Sono lieti di essere qua a Parma in questo convegno e volevo ringraziare prima di tutto a questo magnifico duo dinamico, il professor Canela e il dottor Dernini, che lo fanno riunire sempre in queste interessantissime riunioni. Infatti, piacerebbe parlare italiano, ma mi hanno chiesto di parlare in inglese, così proverò anche di parlare in inglese. Well, as Professor Mancini has told us, really the discovering of the Mediterranean diet, the redefinition was made by Dan Cerchis, and also with the help of Professor Mancini, Professor Fidanza, and also Professor Landecovian, which is something that is very well recognized. So, in a certain way, the redefinition of the Mediterranean diet was done by Americans with the help of Europeans. At the end of the 1980s, we had the opportunity to have an international conference in Europe organized by Professor Helsing and Professor Anna Ferraluzzi, as well as Professor Trigopoulos. That was probably the first international conference on Mediterranean diet. The second one was organized in 1991 in Barcelona by Professor Helsing and myself, both published in international news journals. But really, the first, let's say, well-known international conference was organized in Boston in 1993. And that conference was organized, but always in collaboration with the Harvard University and WHO and FAO. From that conference, it was published the first Mediterranean diet pyramid in 1993. And this pyramid, as you know, has a specific copyright, which pertains to this organization always, which is located in Boston. Obviously, the second visit of American to Europe has not the same, in my opinion, the same purpose than the first one, which was led by Dan Cerchis. The second visit has another additional interest, which is the dissemination of the Mediterranean diet in the United States in America. In 1996, we created the Mediterranean Diet Foundation in Barcelona and we organized the first International Congress on Mediterranean Diet in Barcelona. Now, we are organizing the 8th Congress for the next year, so 8 editions of an international conference in Barcelona. And the Mediterranean Diet Foundation, as you know, is an international organization which is created under the auspice of the Ministry of Agriculture in the Spanish government. And now, our honorary president is the Princess Cristina of the Royal House of Spain. At the same time, that was a emerging the Mediterranean Forum of Food Cultures that was emerging at the beginning of this century in Calabria, which was supported particularly at the regional level. And this initiative was coordinated by Sandro Dernini and supported by Professor Canela. In a certain way, the encounter between these Mediterranean food cultures and the Mediterranean Diet Foundation was the origin of the thoughts around the cultural issues of the Mediterranean diet and the need to defend in front of the UNESCO the fact that Mediterranean diet is more than a healthy pattern, it's a cultural pattern that needs to be preserved. For that reason, the meeting in Parma has an additional interest because we have a drone at this Mediterranean pyramid, which is, in a certain way, our own tool that has not copyright and now could be used by everybody in Europe for educational purposes. So I think it's a very important meeting, the one happened yesterday here in Parma too. Well, I was initially prepared as some reflection about the index evaluating the adherence of the Mediterranean diet, which was prepared with my collaborator, Dr. Anna Bach, which is the scientific coordinator of the Mediterranean Diet Foundation in Barcelona. But I'm going to the last one of the last slides, which is the fact of the trends. No, a little bit before. Little bit next previous one. Previous one. Previous one, that one, yeah. Which is a little bit to explain what has happened with the Mediterranean diet worldwide, in a worldwide context. We have analyzed this within the context of the Mediterranean Diet Foundation, and I think it's very relevant and very important to stress the need to support these the activities on this. This is the map of the Mediterranean diet adherence using the Fidanza index, which is one of the most used, together with the one from Professor Antonio Trikopoulos. And the Fidanza shows that, obviously, the Mediterranean countries, as well as some countries like Chile, has a high adherence to Mediterranean diet pattern in the 60s, 61, 65. Next one. This is in color, you can see in red the highest adherence, and in yellow the lowest one. Next one. This is the trend from the pattern in the year 2000 and 2005, where you can find that particularly several countries like Spain and Italy and Greece has decreased the dietary adherence to the Mediterranean diet pattern, which is in fact still prevalent in the north of Africa, in southern Mediterranean countries. Next one. This is in more detail what is happening. Next one. In fact, if we look at the trends of the Mediterranean diet, there is a huge decrease in Greece, the first one. The second Mediterranean country to decrease is Albania, Turkey, Spain, Portugal, Yugoslavia, Tunisia, Bulgaria, and then Italy, which shows decrease of more than 1.2/6 of the Mediterranean diet adherence. This is the reality. This is the reality. We are losing the traditional Mediterranean pattern. And this is something that is, in a certain way, related to the increased prevalence of obesity that Professor Mancini was explaining to us. Next one. Next one. So I just would like to thank all the team of the Mediterranean Diet Foundation and congratulate the Italian partners for organizing such an important meeting that I think it will be important for the preservation of the Mediterranean diet. Thank you very much.